To Ubabu Mapoloba, Babu Temba Ndobo, who's the patron of the Claremont Choir. Siyabonga kakhulu Fuze for always being with us. We also have Ubabu Nwanase amongst us, Babu Moses Tembe. These are the people that makes us city have life as a choir. And this is why we are here as well. It's through their contributions. And kukhona futhi uSolwazi, Ubaba Umvelase, siyabonga kakhulu for being here. Kukhona uDokotela futhi our deputy city manager eThekwini from community services cluster uDr. Gumbete. Siyabonga mngoni. This is a chorister. Njoba ngimbekela ngathi avela sheshe nje afike stage ashaye ibase. This is our chorister. But amongst us, there is also Asiya Khan with husband from Department of Environmental Affairs in the province. Thank you very much for being here. I know everyone ola endlini. Sister Mrs. Shabalala, kade ngimbuza ukuthi uba uphi ubaba wekhaba, ngiyamazi nawe uyawuthanda lo mculo. But thank you very much for being here. It's a beautiful Sunday afternoon. And I also have to greet our viewers at home. Sanmonani on Facebook, on Twitter, and on Instagram, you call it, you name them. We are connecting live in the social media platforms of the city of eThekwini. Siyababingelela ababukeli nabathandi bomculo nabalandeli nje beClaremont Choir. Bese kuthi ke gcineni ngifise ukubingelela, I'm sending my greetings to our ambassador, Ubaba Xolisa Mabhonga. He is our deputy permanent representative in the United Nations. He is connected with us right now, all the way from New York. We are just wanting to give you a taste of what home is about. South Africa and Durban, especially, it's a warmest place to be. As well as there is a lady who's behind all of this, Michelle. She's also connecting with us right now. Greetings, Michelle. Bon Giovanni, she is in the New Jersey in the United States. Wow, Claremont Choir and Manyan and Trouble. I guess Bani is NG from Belkul Guti. We are connected internationally. We are connected internationally. So it's nothing much, but just the music and a sundowner of some sort, but in a good cause, where we are talking of a good cause, climate change, and doing an awareness. Michelle from Healer World is a founder and CEO of the organization called Healer World. They are doing e-awareness, Dr. Gumede, on climate change, on performing arts, especially on music. Because we all know, Uti, we are having another epidemic now, or pandemic. I think that's the right word, epidemic, pandemic. We've got another pandemic, which is climate change. And we are also having a biggest one here in South Africa, which is gender-based violence, other than the COVID, COVID that we are living under. But we are glad numbers are slowly coming down, and people are still urged to do really restrictions on every movement, social distancing, as I can see, having our masks on. As I can see, all of us here are having our masks on. So we are trying to we've got to be safe. So okay, I will urge all of us here to really please be strict on those COVID restrictions and do our best to stay alive. Ngizocela ke usisi wami la uLasandra uzosivulela inkundla nje. Lasandra, what are you? Is Lasandra in the house?
Yes.
Is Lasandra in the house? She's a youngest singer, and she's doing so well. I want her to start and give us two items. She's from Durban Music School. She's a recording artist. She's now singing in the movies. She was shooting a movie when Chile Zolo. She was shooting a movie, and she's going to shoot also after this. So Ola Sandra uzosivulela inkundla just nje ukuthi sikhuleke. I'm also the CEO of the Claremont Choir, so I can also tell you, be free, nikhumule amabhanzi, niwabeke ngaphezulu, like he has done. So siwakhenge nje ngemuva, and we're gonna have fun, we're gonna really have fun. take the stage, simnyeze izandla ezinkulu la Sandra. Ababukele emakhaya, you have beautiful time. Thank you.
Oh.
That's the talent that we have in Durban. This is how we do, this is how we roll in Durban, eh? This is how we roll in KZN. We have been joined now by our head at the IGR International Governance and Relations, Babu Eric Appelgreen. He's the man that made this possible, the sound, the video. Thank you very much, Eric, for connecting us with the world. So I really had to say, Mpati, because Mpati, you've got to come and see where your money goes as the city. And thanks, Chief Whip and Babu Mguni, for really understanding us. In as much as we are in the pandemic, but we still have to push life going forward, bring hope to the city, bring hope to the world. I was watching a beautiful concert in New York, I think 2 weeks back, saying New York is open for business. So that is what we are trying to do for our city, beautiful city of Durban, to say we are open for business. They are telling us we are in the new normal, we've got to find a way to live with the virus and keeping safe, but economy has to go on. We've got to push our relationships moving forward. And I can agree with Michelle Ugutige, as she's connected with us in New Jersey, we need to be pushing story of climate change, story of social injustices. We have recently seen the looting and the social unrest in our country, in our province mostly, in our city in Durban, but we want to say enough is enough. Our city is a place of prosperity. So Durban is beautiful, isn't it? It's a beautiful city. So thank you very much, Lassandra, beautiful voice. Now, I'm going to give to the host, the Clement Choir, to show us what do they have in store. They've got beautiful music ranging from different aspects of life, social injustices, climate change, and because we know most of you are choral lovers, you'll also hear those pieces in choral music. Let me give over to them and the conductor, uBrian Myandu, Simshayeleni Izandla, uMbhexeshi, umgidi wekwaya. Over to you.
Fumanibo! 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 Say yes to 17 goals of transforming the world. Fumanibo! Yes to sustainable development goals. A clarion call for action by all countries. Poor, rich and middle classes. Fumanibo! Promoting prosperity while protecting the planet. Our mother, youth forward. Next generation carrying a torch forward for a sustainable, safe and healthy world for all. Rise up, people of Mother Earth. End poverty in all its forms everywhere. Say no to poverty. Zero hunger means zero to starvation. No stomach shall sleep empty. Fumanibo! We are for healthy life for all nations. Promoting well-being for all at all ages. We are for quality education for all the children in all corners of the world. Fumanibo! Say no to poverty. Say no to poverty. Fumanibo! To access gender equality and empowering all women and girls. More girls to school. No more girls forced into early marriage. Fumanibo! For education is power. A key to accepting poverty. A key to escaping poverty. Fumanibo! To access water and sanitation. Yes, to clean water and sanitation. Fumanibo! They shall be light for affordable, reliable, sustainable energy for all. Say no to poverty. Fumanibo! We, the people of Earth, are like fish in the water. No fish can live without water. Let us conserve the use of our oceans, marines, and sea. Fumanibo! Life on the land is the way. Let us sustain our forest. Stop land degrading. Fumanibo! let us be one. Imbumba, two minds are better than one. Fumanibo, united we stand, but divided we fall. Fumanibo.
Last night I laid a sleeping, there came a dream so fair. I stood in an old Jerusalem beside a temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sang, me thoughts the voice of angels from heaven answered.
Sanibonani ke futhi. Ayi le mic ayikho strong. Asithathe ni.
1 2.
Well, Clement Choir has just given us a hint of where we are going with our afternoon. It's not going to be a long program, but it's an afternoon of reflecting on climate change, reflecting on social ills, reflecting on the sustainable development goals. So this is why we are meeting this afternoon. Amongst us, because we called you to do this recording, which has been commissioned by Michelle, who's watching us right now from New Jersey in the US, as well as our ambassador, whom we are going to connect in the next few minutes, who is in New York. But we ask for you as our close patrons and close leaders to say, here is a choir that is working in that space. Music, they say it heals. Music builds the nation. So we can do a lot of these to spread the word, spread a good word on climate change, spread a good word on how abantu besifazane should be treated, you know. So thank you very much for being with us this afternoon. I can assure you, you're going to have a beautiful time. Amongst us, I see what we have been joined by Councillor Mpumestrole, who's also a member of EXCO in eThekwini Municipality. Siyakumukela Councillor. Thank you, Simshali Zandanje, Uspalo, Waga Governance. We also have Ubabu Mgonyama, our Ward 32 Councillor. It's very nice to do something in as much as we are called Clement Choir Babu Mgonyama, but you are Durbanites, you know. But it's very nice to do something when you know you've got the leadership of Indawo and endorsing that. And we acknowledge the good work that you do and the support that you give to this school, Durban Music School. Kim Agauvalumlomongawe. Unfortunately, she couldn't be with us. She's not feeling well, but she really told me what you were coming. Thank you very much for that. I know, yes, Ngamshayela Izandla Councillor. And ngineshoko ukuthi uCouncil obuyayo ngineshoko yalokho. Thank you very much. I want to do something unusual. You see, when we're singing this song, The Holy City, we just put it on the program for one person only in this room, Babu Moses Tembe. This was dedicated to you, Ngwanase. And as a close patron of the Clement Choir, supporting us all the way, I know you're going to be leaving to another pressing matter. But I just want you to come on stage and greet and say a few words on behalf of the Clement Choir so that you'll go. And especially I know what he is on the Climate Change Council for the province as well. Ngwanase, just to greet nje and say what are we planning and what do we have in mind about climate change. So your time vakwakhe, I will request Babu Erica Pellegrin to come in as we had as introduced our chief whip. Then we'll connect to our guest. Thank you, Manasa.
Thanks, wise man. And I'm not sure if I should thank you for putting me on the spot. This is really not right. I'm going to stand by the protocols that have been eloquently observed. I'm not going to, don't charge me for defying the protocol. I think let's take the protocols as observed. Ladies and gentlemen, I think it's a great day today for the music lovers, but most importantly, really, I want to take this opportunity to pay homage and heartfelt tribute to the visionary city for making this happen. Not many leaders around our country have understood and have captured the imagination in terms of what could be achieved around harnessing the work of arts and music in particular. I'll tell you a very short story before I sit down. One of the cities around the world, there was so much thuggery, there was so much trouble in the streets of that country. What they decided to do was just to play classical music, and the crime dropped by a whopping 35%. As they say, if music is the food of love, play on. I'm of the view that even the families, if they could just play the music, the love will flow like the sea billows roll. But coming to the essence, the gist and the crux of the day, we are reflecting on climate change. I really do not believe that it's a subject that is not top of mind to each and every one of us. As business people, we are saying to our city, I think it's time we begin to take the subject more seriously. It's time for us to look at alternative sources of energy. It's time for us to look at waste to power. It's time for us to look at gas to power. It's time for us to look at waste in terms of food to power. It's time for us to really reflect on this issue and do something about it. Before I sit down, we're saying to our leaders here, thank you, thank you, thank you to the glorious and harmonious voice of Claremont Choir. You really make our hearts ooze with joy, ooze with enthusiasm to see you flourishing and rising to the next level of professionalism. Thank you to one and all. Thank you.
No, Angiti, I said you are sitting here as a family. Yeah, so it's ngiyabonga ngwanas. I'll keep on doing this. I know everyone who's here. But on this note, I'd like to call Mr. Eric Appelgreen so that he can reflect on the work of the city on international level in terms of climate change and SDGs. It's not the first time that Eric is looking this into a vision. Last year we did almost the same when the United Nations was celebrating 75 years. And this choir was also live in the UN and performing. So again, I think we are trying to put our city in the map, especially with the young people. Our city has got a lot of programs at the IGR and community services that are looking into young people, and we want to say time is now for them to play a role, and not just what is dume uthi nje sisema clubini siyagwazana, but also just good messages of hope. Thank you, Eric, as you're coming forward. Thank you for really supporting us. You'll then introduce our chief whip. We then will connect to ambassador first. Thank you very much, sir.
Good afternoon, everybody. Firstly, I'd like to give my respect and recognition of our Chief Whip, who represents the Mayor's Parlour and the leadership of our city, Councillor Sithole, Councillor Protas from this ward. We're in your house. I'd like to recognize you and my colleague, Dr. Gomede. He's one of my bosses before the other big boss. I'd like to recognize you all and all the other, to Mr. Tembe and Mr. Ngobo, to the patrons of this important choir. And it's not just a choir. Wiseman and these young people have come across a lot. The other important thing is that Claremont, I've got family and friends there. And Claremont has produced many great people. It also went through a very hard, difficult time of violence and bloodshed. And I remember we lost friends and family in Claremont. And Claremont Choir reflects that new beginning in a way, you know. So I'd really like to honor and respect our leadership, but the young people here. And, you know, climate change is not just a politically correct thing to talk about, or because that's the latest thing to talk about. It's not that. Councillor Sithole, I think you're younger than me, I think. Huh? So we older people, we've got to make sure that we create opportunities for you to inherit an earth that you can be proud of, and that earth will give you all the things that you need. And also we need to make sure that the air is clean and the water is clean so that when you sing, your voice doesn't get disrupted, you know, and that the economy of our world can thrive. And Claremont Community Choir is based in eThekwini. eThekwini is part of this major, beautiful continent of ours. And there's a lot of cities and parts of our continent that are under threat because of climate change. People can't get access to water. There's the like us as a coastal city, the threat of flooding is there. So we've got to make sure we do everything in our power. And the important thing here is that a young man like Wiseman is linking us to our ambassador, to the United Nations, to ensure that the voice of young people are there in the corridors of power and not just in City Hall. And we as a city have taken a decision to ensure that we have a climate change plan so that we make sure we can cope with all the things that climate change is going to throw at us. But I'm not here to give you a speech, I'm just here to really add my voice to what Mr. Tembe said, to recognize the work of the Claremont Community Choir and really urge everybody to get behind these young people and their singing and their lobbying and advocacy work to create a better life in our city really must be applauded. And we wish you 120% success in whatever you do. But more importantly, we want to continue hearing your voices. And I think I might be saying the wrong thing now. Like, I'm there's that choir that sings Glorious. The one that sings at the ICC, they make lots of money and they're really famous. MTN sponsors them. No, but I really do believe that there'll come a day when Claremont Community Choir is going to be that group that's going to make us go to higher levels. So ladies and gentlemen, I really give you my heart and my support. And that's when Wiseman comes and asks me to support, I don't hesitate. And so without further ado, I would like to introduce our leadership, represented by our Chief Whip, Councillor Mkize, to come and speak on behalf of our leadership of the city. Let's give him a round of applause.
Thank you very much. Thanks, I'm going to fast. The CEO of Claremont Community Choir, Kabazela, and the entire choir. I know that there is an ambassador, UN ambassador to climate change, Babma Bongo, who is connected online, and Michelle, who is online as well, the chairperson of governance and HR, Councillor Sithole, and Councillor Proteas, the ward councillor, greeting you, Councillor, the DCM, Babu Kumete, and all the officials from the different spheres of our government, the business people who are here, and my wife, Makili, and all the participants who are here, good afternoon. On behalf of the mayor, we want to applaud the Claremont Community Choir for taking the stand to make the awareness on the climate change. I remember Councillor Stole, it was 2000, if I'm not mistaken, at Mafikeng, at the ANC conference, Mgun. In the commission, there was this item of climate change. And there were very few people who had interest to attend that commission. Because at that time, there was like, there is no need for us to talk about it. And now we are here. So we are here to say, let us all preserve our environment on behalf of the mayor. Let us not cut all the trees. Let us not burn the fuels. Let us minimize the burning of things that will destroy the ozone layer. I remember when I was at school that when we burn chemicals, Mguni, it can destroy the ozone layer, and our people, our children will have a skin cancer at a very early age, and also the eyesight problem. And we are observing the disaster because of this climate change. So we are saying on behalf of the mayor, let us all make sure that we conserve our environment and we make sure that our climate change is of a good condition so that our generation will live in a better place. But lastly, Durban is a better place to be. I know, Mguni, that in one of the meetings, I said, it was like I was joking when I said, for me, let us open the candle. And I said that. I want to encourage all of you let us take our vaccination so that we'll go to the normal life. Let us all vaccinate. Let us take our jab. I have taken mine, the first one, and the second one. We are in a very nice environment now because the regulation are easing down. We want all of you to take your jab so that we make sure that we go back to the normal life and have this fine again. I can't wait to see more song from Clement Community Choir and all other musicians who are here. Thank you very much.
Wale Mumbo. It's music now. There is a song that they are going to do. It's they call it Clement Choir Medley, African Medley. So after that song, we'll then connect to Ambassador. I'm sure he's online, Ambassador Mapongo. And thereafter, we'll then welcome Michelle. Can I give it to conductor on the Clement Choir? Marshall is under Bantabam, the Sasuhu. Over to you. Thank you, Clement Choir. Thank you very much. This is an African medley. The very last song that they did, the piece of Kabingoma, it's a song by the late Ubaba Uphelelani Mnomiya. I wash our pumu mama Mnomiya. Just wanted to greet and say, siyabonga kini de wahlala phansi. Siyabingelela sisilungi. You can see umsebenzi kaBaba is still living, even though he's no longer with us. So this is the beautiful piece, Kabingoma. And now if we band, Mnomiya was another person altogether. Siyabonga ma, siyabonga kakhulu. Thank you, Clement Choir. We are about now to be joined by our ambassador, Deputy Permanent Representative in the United Nations. Hey, yeah, Saba, it's very important in the technology. Can we get to Ambassador online so to have a small conversation and greeting to him? Can we connect to you, Babu Mapongo, from New York?
I hope you can hear me.
We can hear you perfectly, Ambassador. How are you, sir?
I'm very well, thank you very much. And congratulations on this most wonderful afternoon, morning for us here in the US. But I just wanted to say to the CEO and to all the leaders that are present, all protocol observed, and to Michelle, who is in New Jersey, we are very pleased to be associated with the Clement Choir. I think the initiative that you have taken today is most important as we prepare for COP26, which is going to be one of the most important and perhaps one of the most difficult COPs on climate change. The reason is simple. A few weeks ago, the Intergovernmental Panel on Climate Change issued their latest report. And according to that report, we are now on course between 2030 and 2052 to actually reach the 1.5 centigrade of global warming. And of course, if we don't do anything drastic between now and 2030 and 2052, it means by the end of the century, we could actually reach 2 degrees and 3 degrees. This is a big red flag, because if we go above 1.5 to 2 and 3, many things will change in life. As some of the leaders who spoke already referred to some of the current effects of climate change. Sea level rise, ocean acidification could mean that for coastal states like South Africa, we will see so much devastation, which will be permanent for the next millennia. We won't be able to enjoy resources of our oceans, such as the fish, because there will be no fish. Fish will not survive in the ocean at 2 and 3 degrees. So this latest report of the IPCC is really, really a big red flag that we all should take seriously. The second thing that the report says is that some of the effects of climate change that we are seeing now may already be permanent. There is nothing that we can do about them. So we see all over the world, in the Americas, both in North and South America, we see in Europe, we see in Asia, we see in Africa, our own continent. We see extreme weather events, from rainfalls to storms, and also on the other side to desertification. So these are some of the challenges that we are grappling with as a result of climate change. Our own government, as you are aware, is preparing to attend COP26 at Glasgow. As of now, President Ramaphosa is confirmed to attend in person. This is the importance that we attach to this phenomenon and topic. So in South Africa, of course, our position is closely aligned with the broader African position, which is to seek a just transition, that as we address climate change, we must also still have the policy space to pursue economic growth and development. And also to recognition by the world that in fact, Africa was not responsible for the historical emissions. So therefore, we still want those member states who are responsible for the historical emissions to be the ones who undertake the most responsibilities to address climate change. We are not shrinking from our own responsibility. Our government at the moment is in a process of finalizing the updated national determined contributions. So we will do our part, that is our commitment. But at the same time, we want a just transition that allows developing countries to also have policy space to do economic growth and development. So when I see initiatives like the ones that you have taken today, we are heartened as representatives of South Africa at the UN that back home, this issue is being engaged on, not just at the national level of the national government, but also by provinces, by cities, by communities, as the example of the Clement Choir shows. We have no option. We have all to take action at all levels to deal with climate change. As I said before, this IPCC report basically says some of the things that were already seen as a result of climate change, there is virtually nothing that we can do about them. They will be with us for the rest of our lives. And I just also wanted to add one word on COVID to support the leadership that has spoken to say, let's go and get our jobs where we can, let's play our responsibility also there. Because again, COVID, the sooner we're able to get hold of COVID, or COVID as the world, the better for all of us. We saw the strangle that COVID has had on our economies for 2 years now. And we need to get out of this cycle. And to get out of this cycle requires individual responsibility. It's not just the responsibility of government, but individuals, as we go and do our jobs, we are protecting ourselves by protecting our neighbors as well, protecting our co-workers so that we can all go back to our work spaces. With those few words, I just again wanted to thank you and congratulate you and say this is why I see this as one of the most important initiatives that you have undertaken. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Ambassador. It's always a pleasure engaging with you, and I can attest because when the city and the province brought me to the UN in 2019, you welcomed us in New York in your offices beautifully, and we had a lot of engagements that are talking to this. You didn't just say those words when we were there, but you've also contributed to our program of action as the Clement Choir when we're engulfed by the COVID. You donated towards us to raise those food groceries to the communities. On behalf of the leadership who are here, Ambassador, we really want to thank you very much. And we now know that we've got a home. Clement Choir is celebrating 30 years in 2022. And it's a massive 30 years. And it is our wish to tour the world, including USA. And now we know that you will be there with us and supporting us. Thank you for those words on climate change. I know, Uti, when you're talking of the IPCC report, the carbon emissions, many of us in the communities do not really understand what is it. But as Durban, as a city, we are a coastal city. We have got Ulwandle, and the more Lungcibiliki Ulwandle from amazwe lawa, like the Abo Iceland, it gets fuller and it comes closer. So it means laba bakhe lapha ama hotel lawa ngasolwandle honke o Suncoast na honke, they'll be getting flooded. And we have seen those kind of floods in Durban in the recent time. Actually, even last week, New York and Durban were hit by heavy floods. So it tells Uti climate change is real and it's happening. So we all have to take an action. Thank you very much, Ambassador, for connecting us so early in the morning. It's 6 hours, we are 6 hours ahead of New York. We will be connecting again to Michelle Bongiovanni, who is behind all of this, and she really wanted to take Clement Choir to Glasgow for COP26. Hey, but I'm not sure she's vaccinated, Dr. Musa Gumede. I'm not sure. God, Michelle will talk. Our leaders are here. Are you vaccinated? Oh, okay. Thank you, Ambassador Eric Wizweleg. So let me welcome again the climate change song. We've got a special song on climate change. Dr. Gumede, Zumuntu Spatele Zamatrigo, Nomyoningo, Ngasishizulu. We've got a song on climate change that was composed. Where is Nonzwakazi? Our one and only Nonzwakazi, who will come, she composed this song and she put it together with the choir because we want to add a voice, Michelle, there. She's enjoying the show and she was telling me now that we are really playing our part on climate change. Over to you, choir. We've got a lot of music. We've got K-Cap, Ensemble Babu Jomanuko, and Allah. We've got other singers, Unzuzo Lapa from ETDMS. We're trying to Uguba, Tuayini, Iskaka, Sibenda Onion, and say Durban can do it.
When you are ready, take us through. Our viewers are watching at home. Nangu Nonzwakazi, asimshayele ihlombe for composing this song on climate change. She's so gifted. Thank you. Indeed, a new world has begun. Thank you very much, Clement Kwaya and Nonzwakazi, for those two items, especially the climate change song. Unjomane une studio lapha eKCAP kwaMashu. Beautiful studio. Usengibizile ukuthi this song must be recorded properly in studio. We'll definitely call you Mguni, and I'm glad Kono Babu Temba Mthunu, our bishop. Our bishop there, who's the good thing about him is he's an artist before he can be an administrator. He understands. And every time when you say to him, I'm doing this, he'll always be there. Siyabonga amaqhingwane. So ngenzela nje ukuthi ngikufake nje ngikufake esiqhaweni so ukuthi ngiyakukomitha njobe sekhulumile ubaba uNjomane ukuthi sesilenza ne KCAP ensemble. They are called Actors Incubation Mentorship Program. They were going to do one piece later on in the program together so that we can bring our city that hope, that beauty. And it will be nice to really commit as the city to assist. And just show other cities. Yes, you only go to Cape Town. I was there last week. And when you say you're from Durban, you can see ukuthi bakubuka kambi because they can feel ukuthi izigi zethu zikhona. You know, they can feel ukuthi we're there as Durban. And unfortunately, mase kuyi festive season, they have to come to us. Because their ocean, Atlantic Ocean, is very cold. Michelle, I'm about to connect to you, and it is my honor and privilege to introduce you to South Africa, to our leaders of the city of Durban, and to our mentors and mentees who are here. I'm hoping you can hear us. Here is the lady who's behind all of this, Miss Michelle Bon Giovanni. I like this surname. It sounds beautiful. Welcome, Michelle.
Thank you.
Welcome, Michelle.
Thank you.
When I was introduced to Michelle, it was through, oh, by the way, guys, I'm the ambassador for climate change for South Africa. Yes. So I was introduced to Michelle. I was introduced to Michelle through our network in the United Nations, and they said, there is a lady who's doing so much in music. Justice for climate change, you know. And I followed, there's a beautiful concert that Michelle, you hosted in Atlanta, I think 2 years ago, and it was beautiful. Music about passion and building the society. So we are very grateful and honored that you trusted us as the choir. Even though we are recording this and we'll embed it beautifully for the program of the launch of Glasgow COP26, but we said, let us go a step higher, and thanks to the city, especially Office of Babu Eric Appelgreen for taking this live, as well as the communications unit. Bekhona Babu Philip Stole as well, our DCM in the space car planning. Babu Lihlepe was helping us on this, but we appreciate you, Michelle, even for your contributions to help us getting the band, getting this and that. Welcome to Durban, and let me give you to greet us and say a few words about the project that we are doing. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Wiseman. Can you hear me?
Perfectly.
Wonderful. So it is my great honor, so humbled to be here with you from halfway across the world today, and to hear this beautiful and inspiring performance that you've kindly put together, Wiseman, on very quick notice. I want to thank the ambassador, the city of Durban, all of the government officials who are here today, as well as the choir. This is some of the most inspiring music I think I personally have ever heard. I think I'm so touched because the spirituality with which you sing, we need that inspiration at this moment in time. As the ambassador said, this is a critical moment for us all and for our planet. Music for Climate Justice is a global initiative where we're bringing together musicians from around the world, all in support of our climate and planet Earth. And some of the issues that we wish to bring to attention at COP26 through this program are really surrounding the injustices of climate change, that it's the most marginalized in our society. Women, children, those that are indigenous, peoples of brown and black descent, who are the most impacted by the effects of climate change. And we all need to care about that, because there is great injustice that is a part of the climate problem. And this is something that we're very much committed to raising awareness about. I don't know if you all have seen, but there was a recent study that was also just released by UNICEF saying that over one third of our children across the globe are going to be negatively impacted by climate change. Over a billion children represents about a third of all children globally. So it is our responsibility to give them a better world and to give them hope. And we believe that through the voices of your wonderful choir and others who are joining in, we can create inspiration for our young people and our youth to know that we do love them, we care, we're here, and that we are all in this fight against climate change, not just the government officials, not just the UN, but all of us as citizens of this planet, of planet Earth. And so I ask you to please pray and celebrate these beautiful performances that will be a part of our launch, which will be at COP26. We're targeting November 4th for our launch. There'll be an in-person part of the event from COP, and then we'll go to our pre-produced segment, which will include this lovely performance. And so I just ask you to all join in together to continue the wonderful work. We hope to elevate your beautiful work here in the U.S. Happy to talk to the ambassador about your wonderful program here in the U.S. and to see whatever we can do to elevate it, because it's just tremendous. And so I thank you for all of your heart, your inspiration, and your beauty. Thank you so much, Wiseman, for putting this together.
Thank you very much, Michelle, for, I know it's very early in the morning as well in New Jersey, but you took your time to connect and wanting to see what we've been talking about via emails and MS Teams meetings that we have had. But thank you for believing in us. And it's a good thing that now we have joined yourself and our ambassador in New York to say we can bring the message of hope for South Africa, the message of hope for our city of Durban. And wow, guys, Michelle said we'll be playing live this performance at the launch of Glasgow. So Durban will be there and represented, Chief Whip. So that's very good. Thank you very much, Michelle. We shall connect and we shall send the edited version, but at least now you know our leaders and they sending their appreciation to you for trusting us. Thank you. Now we are moving on. We're going to introduce Hloniphani. Hloniphani Mthethwa is a graduate from AKK Kwamashu. He's doing wonders with his guitar now. So Hloniphani, take the stage. After Hloniphani, we'll also welcome umsebenzi kaBaba Njomane from there kwaMashu AKK. Abantu bazokuthi uMashu nje kunezinto nje ezingezinhle ezenzakalayo. KwaMashu khona izinto ezinhle. Like KK. Angithi KK. Yeah, so you'll see them on stage and so the beautiful work. We're trying to do this as a Claremont Choir to say we as artists, we can work together. Even though it's now we're dealing with classical or choral or opera music, but they are doing our African indigenous music and we are about that. So while sesaxhuma ke siyabonga kakhulu Hloniphani for giving us this. Nonzwakazi will also be back. I just want to just give music. Ingabe ngiseza la. Kuzoba uHloniphani. Ibizi ensemble, my kaita nje, just give us two items, then is the ensemble, then sekuzu nonzwakazi, then we shall close with the Claremont Choir. Sorry to swamba ngakahlwa kakhulu. Over to you, sir.
Mainile Tata Amatunga ngiyakhongozela bese uhamba uyochelela ngoba umpompi namapiti yayi umthombo wokuphuza thina thina Tate tati zembatho shone mlanjeni uwashana bondanga izingane zakwenu ngoba umpompi namapiti yayi umthombo wokuphuza thina bantu kazana thina emkhaya thatha mbalwa maqhathi izinkomo ziphuze ngezathwe babancela umgade webabancela umgade lo emkhaya thatha mbalwa maqhathi izinkomo ziphuze ngezathwe babancela umgade webabancela umgade lo Bye. chana ungazo fele mawe nibuya uzo taela uyele kaya watu tuamba yegubu kazi kazi bempilo iska chana ungazo fele mawe nibuya uzo
Hamba, hamba, hamba. Oh, hamba, 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 hamba. Buyele. I can say it, ne? Well, let us welcome Actors Incubation Mentorship Program from Gwamashu Community Arts Advancement Programs, AKCAP. Sibanike izihlombe beseza. Uhloniphane should be there on stage again with them. They are going to give us two items because of time. Sesizophinda sicela unzuzo after them. Iyobe siyazivalela ke Clement Choir. Hloniphane, we need you on stage for this performance. It's very good to see our young people engaged in the arts, which we believe it keeps them safe from all the social ills. So thank you very much, Bantabami, for Ukloni Pubam Jomani.
Thank you.
before I just want to say a few things about this song. It was just composed immediately after the social unrest to say, let us love one another, black, Indians, and whites. And let's give a shout to Babu Njomane and for doing this wonderful job with these kids. So thank you very much. Yes. Let's love one another. Let us spread love. And it is in studio right now to release it formally. Let's do our last number. Bantu Bakamashu. Siyabonga.
Kani kakhulu lesihlobo esibashayela manje. Kani kakhulu. Siyabonga abantu abazi. Let's also give up to our band. Beautiful guys, you've been working very hard. We really pay respect to you for being with us. Upumahlase on the keys. Siyabonga kakhulu bafowethu. Let's welcome Zuzo Meyiwa from Durban Music School. He's going to give us one item, and then we're going to have the Clement Choir closing the show with our items, our four very hot items. Then we call it a day. Are you still having a good time? Are you sure? Thank you very much. Nzuzo, over to you. Siyabonga. These institutions are doing very well at eThekwini, both the KCAP and DMS. Siyabonga kakhulu for the work of abantu abasha and produce such talent, which we need then to show in the world. And as Zabo Michelle and Ambassador are watching, I'm sure opportunities will be there. But Clement Kwai, close the show now. God, this figgy lila. Sifunu, sisonto. Nama campaigns, I'm aninga, first year ones. Skyayil. Skyayil. Izwe, womb, Izwe. Sister, register, look for it. Are we registered to vote? They're going to give us, I think, 3 or 4 items of closing the show. If you feel like standing up and joining them and sing, you can. It's a beautiful song. You need this one. Ha, so cool, I'm pity, man.
Yeah.
shall be open to all, let the voice of freedom ring from roll to all, change must come right now, change must come right now,
break the chains of torturing pain.
Yes, if I had to. triumphant and all. Do you still recall the fateful night we crossed the Rio Grande? I can see it in your eyes, how proud you were to fight for freedom in this land.
Ensemble, please join us on stage. We are about to do We Are the World, the songs that we're going to do all together. Hloniphani, please welcome back Hloniphani on stage and the KCAP Ensemble. Shani Zandapen. Teddy, our beautiful poet, please come back on stage as well.
Well, this is the last collaboration piece, We Are the World, Heal Our World. It's important message at this time, and it's good to see all of them on stage. So I want to thank each and every one of you, my leaders, who really took your time and be here with us today. It means a lot to us. The Chief Whip, Mamos Choile, Babu Kansela, Kakulu, sihlezi silana-ke sine-ward 32 baba kodwa-ke sesiyingane zakho-ke siyayi-adopt-a nathi njengamanje siyayi-adopt-a nje kakhulu sizosebenza kakhulu siye phambili sakhe intsha nje yala it's very bad to see our young people be-entrenched in drugs and the, all sort of social ills. Thank you very much. I want to thank this young man bengazi ngizosho kanje. He is the owner of all this equipment and what he charged us to see a young black guy doing so much. Thank you very much, Babu Mbatha. Abaga Mbatha, abaga bani ya nazi ya mani. Hey, waze watagaze, wasi abonga mganam for doing all of this. Thanks. Talukbonga, finally, talukbonga all the artists that participated. Nonzwagaze Shine, Nonzwagaze. Nonzwagaze Babu Mthunzi, as you know, is a product of this choir, and it's good to see her now as a recording artist, as a male, but she always knows where home is.
Yes.
Thank you very much, Nonzwagaze. Siyabonga kakhulu.
Yes.
Ngicela ukubonga also Hloniphani, the young man with the guitar.
Yes.
Shonpani, why are you doing this? Wabopa manje. Babu DCM akayithande le ndawo. Akuyona pirates la nje. So not one skipper. Our beautiful band, guys. The special izandle inkosi sabo. Yes. Our crew, both on the sound desk and there, kulezinto zobuchwepheshe ikwazi ukusenza sibonakale like this. Siyabonga kakhulu. There is also a young lady who's an engineer, uNonhlanhla. uNonhlanhla, she came to a show, but she's working now. Angimazi wenzani, kusegazini. uNonhlanhla is a sound engineer. I saw her with MEC Izolo with their mobile studio. Very good, and thank you very much to all the leaders. But on top of that, kunabantu behind all of this. Zama, osukume Zama. She used to be here, manje say behind the scenes. Thank you very much. Thank you. There is also Asanda, who's doing all the work behind the scenes as well, guest maintenance and all of that. Siyabonga Asanda. And Umphile, laphaya Umphile. Siyabonga kakhulu. So, we have just adopted you as our young Clermont Choir, the small Clermont Choir. We're going to work together, and Jomane has assured us we'll be working together a lot and produce to showcase what Durban is about. Thank you very much from AKCAP. Thank you, iFunzuzu Sekona from DMS, Siyabonga. Beautiful Clermont Choir, CCF. Thank you, guys. You are amazing. Thanks. It's not easy to put something like this together. Communications. She has been believing in this since she started. Thank you, Sis Nonhlanhla. Facebook, it's live. At least abantu abasithuki namhlanje ukuthi bafuna izindlu nani. Babuka some beautiful music online. Siyabonga to our viewers at home. We love you so much. This is Durban. Durban is a home of many beautiful things. Thank you very much. Last song. How ukho ndathi kuthiwa ngimbonge naye. Sinaye, sitogether. Sitogether, Lusha.
Thank you. there's nothing we can't conquer.
Let us all realize that a change can only come when we come together as one.
We are the world.
We are the children.
Together, if we care enough for the living, so take a little space.